Hi and welcome to episode number 5 of Keys Unlimited. So I spoke about the one way of accompanying. So here's the second and the third way of accompanying yourself, which can make it sound interesting. So last episode we looked at the tonic, the subdominant and the dominant. So using the first, the fourth and the fifth notes from the key signature and using those chords to accompany yourself. But again, mixing and matching straight chords versus arpeggiated chords to make it more interesting. The other way, and I would actually highly recommend this, is to alternate legato passages with staccato passages. So what's legato and what's staccato? So legato is playing in a way that a swan will glide in a lake. It's extremely smooth. So I would do, and staccato is of course giving a note exactly the time signature but nothing more, and then removing your hand out of it. So it's like playing it like that without giving any of the connections between the notes. So staccato, by the way, doesn't mean poking at the notes. I've seen a lot of children do that. That's not staccato. Staccato is just giving the note its time signature. Just play the note and then take your hand off without giving the connection to the next note. So how do we alternate these two and get something interesting? So let's say we take a song like this is called Yesham Mastani, and it comes from a movie called Kati Patang, long, long before you were born, or actually even I was born. In this song, again, note that I'm only using the key signature of G, the subdominant, which is C, and the dominant, which is D. So I'm just using these three chords. Staccato and legato together, arpeggios and straight notes together. So lots of things to remember, but it's simple. Staccato, legato, so note that I've actually used all four together. Of course I make it look simple, but even if you just do legato and staccato alternatively, why does it sound so nice? It sounds nice also because I'm not putting too much weight on my left hand. My left wrist is very, very loose. Okay? One of the things that you need to remember is when you're playing what I keep hearing, especially a lot of young students do, is using their left wrist very heavily, so it ends up becoming, it doesn't need that, it just legato, very soft. I just played one note throughout and then changed it to again the subdominant. So just with two chords, and I just maintain the pulse. So until then, stay tuned to Keys Unlimited with me, Anand Srinivasan.